Welcome to the TIP TV Finance Show. It's 10 a.m. Monday, the 3rd of July. Looking at the headlines in business and finance today. And most popular, the world's leading drug companies are turning to artificial intelligence to improve the hit-and-miss business of finding new medicine, with GlaxoSmithKline unveiling a new $43 million deal in the field on Sunday. Not a big amount of money, if one thinks about it. Moving along, we've got British business leaders have been told to brace for the possibility that Prime Minister Theresa May's government may walk out of Brexit talks this year, according to the Sunday Telegraph. Next, factories across the Eurozone rounded off the first half of 2017 by ramping up activity at the fastest rate for over 6 years as rising prices failed to put a dent in orders, a survey showed today. IHS Markets Manufacturing Purchasing Managers Index for the Eurozone rose to 57.4% in June, up from May's 57, and pipping the preliminary reading of 57.3. So Eurozone continuing to take off while we are standing rather shy in the corner at the moment. The economic calendar, the market manufacturing PMI in the US, ISM manufacturing PMI also from the US and the ISM prices paid. Obviously tomorrow is Independence Day, so it'll be rather a quiet half day for our American cousins. In the in New Zealand, we've got business confidence, which is a minor economic event. Going on to FX sentiment powered by Oanda, and not too many changes, still going more short of cable towards the $1.30 level. That's obviously the best level we've seen for cable in quite some time, so traders selling into that. Traders also very short of euro dollar, as they have been all the way up, and also short of the Aussie dollar, 50-50, or slightly more on the long side actually, therefore the dollar yen, and very short of euro sterling. Move on to the broker recommendations with Purple Bricks, which has been one of the highlights of the year to date in terms of stock market rises, probably that one in Boohoo, but the hybrid estate agent buy at Citigroup with a target of £5.55. I think the shares are a couple of pounds short of that at the moment, but the way they're moving, anything is possible. Then McCall's Retail Group, which was over the weekend cited as being possibly involved in a deal with Sainsbury's, as Sainsbury's looks to expand its offering in terms of convenience stores and other smaller operations. And then Credit Suisse, Dixon's Carphone, that's their pick in terms of being an outperform, which is a reiteration of their previous call, but just trimming the target a little. But obviously last week we did see Dixon's come up with a better than expected performance as it battles against the likes of Amazon. That's it for the start of the TIP TV Finance Show. Stay tuned for more. Welcome to the Proactive Investors Bulletin Board, where we're looking at Premier Oil, which today agreed to increase its stake in Britain's biggest onshore oil field, acquiring 3.75% of Wytch Farm on the south coast. The deal with Maersk sees Premier paying $11.7 million for the additional interest in the 15,000 barrel per day field, bringing its stake to 33.8%, and payback anticipated as soon as the next 2 years, which seems like a good deal. Looking at the daily chart, you can see that Premier has been in a falling wedge, it's a bullish wedge, a bullish formation rather, since December last year. Top of the wedge there at 53 pence, end of day close above that, could take the stock back up to the main resistance here, which is the 200-day moving average at 66 pence over the next 1 to 2 months.